तो चलिए अब आपको सीधे लिए चलते हैं वित्त मंत्री निर्मला सीतारमण की प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में।
आत्मनिर्भर भारत फर्स्ट द ऑनरेबल एफएम एंड एमओएस विल ब्रीफ देन वी विल टेक सम क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम यू ओवर टू फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर।
Good afternoon. Can you hear me with my mask or should I remove it? Are you okay? It's better now? Good afternoon. I'm sure all of you will have heard the Honorable Prime Minister speak last night to the nation. He laid out a vision, a comprehensive vision. And that vision was laid out after wide and deep consultation with several sections of our society. And these discussions were held at various levels, with various ministries, and also gradually taken up to the level of the Prime Minister's office. And the Prime Minister himself has been spending considerable time to make sure that the inputs obtained are given due consideration and they form a part of the package that's being given to the country. Essentially, this is to spur growth and to build a very self-reliant India. And that's where this whole initiative is called as Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan. And the word Atmanirbhar India is the one which you will be hearing me say quite often. I know coming from South India, a lot of people wondered what it actually meant. So for their benefit, I'll just say what it means in the four languages, subject of course to perfectionist corrections. Suya Sarbu Bharatam in Tamil. Suya Adharitta in Telugu, Suyam Asarittan in Malayalam, and Swayam Alam Avalambitta in Kannada. Subject to correction, it may not be the perfect translation, but something to take it closer to what it means. So Atmanirbhar Bharat is what we are talking about. And you heard the Prime Minister clearly say that this is going to be resting on five important pillars. Five important pillars: the economy, infrastructure, technology-driven systems, demography, and demand. So if these are the five pillars on which we are trying to build Atmanirbhar Bharat, the focus obviously will be what can be defined as the factors of production of, in today's language, factors of production. All of us know that we've been hearing it: land, labor, capital, and enterprise. Today, we recast it, say it the same way, but then essentially referring to the very same factors of production, but in this Atmanirbhar Bharat, our focus therefore would be on those factors of production, which are land, labor, liquidity, and law. So essentially, it addresses issues of ease of doing businesses, ease of doing, compliance and regulations being due diligence observed, and so on. And in this, the intention is to build brands. Intention is also to take local brands and build them to a global level. So there is a global value chain integration also as a part of this vision, which the Prime Minister has put before us. Certainly, when he says Atmanirbhar Bharat, it is not to look inwards and cut India to become an isolationist country. It certainly talks about a confident India, which can rest on its strengths and also be able to contribute to the globe, the way in which the Prime Minister rightly pointed out. The production of PPE and masks and also ventilators to an extent has rapidly grown within these 40 days. We have the capability, we have the enterprise to build such capabilities and help the world with it. And therefore, India shall continue contributing to the globe. You've also been seeing, I'm moving away from Prime Minister's last night's speech, you've been seeing that the government being led by Prime Minister Modi, even in 2014-19 regime, was a listening, was a sensitive, and also was a responding government. And that is why I list before you the various reform-driven steps which have been successfully taken. It's important for us to recall that now, even as we talk about building a new India, building an India which is going to be Atmanirbhar. If I were to group them into different categories and list out what has been done by this government, even in between 2014 and 19, if you were to talk about the poor, we had the DBT-based reforms, based on which today, as we look at the migrants, look at the poor, look at the lockdown in their lives and the impact it has made in their lives, the DBT enabled us to directly put money into their accounts, and they didn't even have to go to the bank to collect it. The bank mitras were able to come and deliver the money, and therefore that reform based on Jan Dhan accounts, based on Aadhaar, and based on mobile technology has brought a revolution in this country, which many countries do recall now, and many of them are not able to do it, although India is able to do it. So for the poor, the DBT, the micro insurance schemes, PM Awas Yojana, Ujjwala Yojana, again something which has made it possible for people to have free cooking gas in the last 3 months. It wouldn't have been possible to reach out to the poor to have their cooking gas given unless the Ujjwala scheme was so successfully implemented. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and Ayushman Bharat. And therefore, for the poor, during the last tenure, the several schemes which benefited were all reform-driven. If I were to talk about agriculture in the same spirit, PM Fasal Bima Yojana, PM Kisan Yojana, which again has come off handy, that we were able to front-load the money to the Kisan during this lockdown. Otherwise, it wouldn't have been possible. Creating new fisheries department, Krishi Sinchai Yojana, were all aimed at bringing reform in agriculture. Similarly, talking of business and also trying to bring in better business environment, PSB cleanups happened, public sector banks cleanup, after a heavy load of phone banking resulting in NPAs, public sector banks recapitalization, FDI liberalization, ease of doing business reforms, which were taken down to the third level of administration governance, IBC reforms, GST reforms, and today because of the GST reforms, you're able to see what impact lockdown is having on small and medium businesses. And finally, reforms in other areas, very quickly to recall, National Highway Authority, the TOT plans, the airport privatizations, power sector reforms, which resulted in India becoming a power surplus country. from shortages always. 175 gigawatts of solar targets out of 86 gigawatt has already been achieved out of that number. And cleaning up of the coal mine sector. These are all things which I would want to recall here before we talk about what we are offering in the Atmanirbhar Bharat. This is the foundation. This is the credential with which the Prime Minister has always been on the side of reform, reform for better living in this country, ease of living in this country.
नमस्कार. कोविड 19 में देश और दुनिया के सामने बहुत सारे संकट खड़े किए और इन चुनौतियों के समय में भी भारत के यशस्वी प्रधानमंत्री आदरणीय मोदी जी अवसर देखते हैं और कहीं ना कहीं पिछले कल का उनका जो देश के प्रति संबोधन था उसमें स्पष्ट तौर पर दिखता है कि आत्मनिर्भर भारत बनाने के लिए ये जो संकल्प उन्होंने लिया है, ये जो सोच अपनी देश के सामने रखी है, इसने एक नई ऊर्जा देशवासियों में भर दी है. जहां अपने घरों तक सीमित थे लोग, आज वो आत्म भारत, आत्मनिर्भर भारत बनाने के इस संकल्प में जुड़ने जा रहा है और संकट में अवसर देख रहा है. और शायद यही कारण है कि दुनिया के मुकाबले अगर भारत का देखा जाए तो इस लड़ाई में बहुत अच्छे कदम रहे. यहां तक कि दुनिया भर के देशों में दवाइयां तक पहुंचाने का भी संकट के समय में अगर किसी ने काम किया तो भारत की दवाइयों की कंपनियों ने किया, जिसमें भारत को बहुत प्रशंसा भी मिली है. यही नहीं, सबसे पहले कोविड 19 को चलते मोदी सरकार ने जो पहला कदम उठाया वो प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण योजना के रूप में लेकर आए कि देश के गरीब को भूखा ना रहना पड़े, उसको कोई दुख तकलीफ ना हो. और 1,70,000 करोड़ का यह पैकेज माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी ने आप सबके सामने रखा था. और यही नहीं, कंप्लायंस की कोई दिक्कत ना हो कि आपको कानूनी तौर पर वैधानिक रूप से कोई जो नियमों का पालन कर रहा है उसमें आप रहना जाएं तो उसकी भी छूट, 3 महीने का मॉरेटोरियम पीरियड आपको दिया गया. फिर आरबीआई के माध्यम से भी घोषणाएं हुई जिसमें लिक्विडिटी का फायदा आप सबको मिला, देश के करोड़ों लोगों को. तो मेरा मानना यह है कि रिफॉर्म्स की जब माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी बात करते हैं कि आत्मनिर्भर भारत हमने बनाना है तो उसके 5 स्तंभ की उन्होंने बात की है, 5 पिलर्स की बात की है, जिसके विस्तार में उल्लेख माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी ने किया है. मैं एक बात इसमें और कहना चाहता हूं कि ये जो हम इकोनॉमी की बात करते हैं, अर्थव्यवस्था की बात करते हैं, पहला स्तंभ आधारभूत ढांचा हमारा ऐसा हो जो आधुनिक हो. और यही नहीं, हमारे सिस्टम जो है वो 21वीं शताब्दी में हमें विश्वगुरु बना सकें उस लायक हम बनाएं. वाइब्रेंट डेमोग्राफी की हम बात करते हैं, युवा शक्ति को हम राष्ट्र शक्ति और राष्ट्र निर्माण के रूप में लगाएं और उनका लाभ उठाएं. और डिमांड को कैसे बढ़ाना है और डिमांड सप्लाई चेन का समन्वय कैसे बना रहे और अर्थव्यवस्था आगे और कैसे बढ़े, इसके इस्तेमाल को करने की भी जरूरत है. बोल्ड रिफॉर्म्स का पूरा लेखा जोखा माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी ने पिछले 6 वर्षों का दिया है. मैं यही कहूंगा, बड़े निर्णय करने के लिए मोदी जी जाने जाते हैं. चाहे वो गुजरात में आए भूकंप के समय वापस कच्छ को खड़े करने की बात हो या आज के संकट के समय भारत में पीपीई और मास्क के निर्माण की बात हो. और कहीं ना कहीं यही सोच भारत को आत्मनिर्भर भारत बनाने जा रही है. और इस आत्मनिर्भर भारत जो मूवमेंट है इसमें हम आप सबको जोड़ने आए हैं. 20 लाख करोड़ का ऐतिहासिक पैकेज माननीय मोदी जी ने पिछले कल घोषणा की है और प्रधानमंत्री जी ने हमें निर्देश दिया है कि प्रतिदिन अलग अलग सेक्टर्स को लेकर आप सबके बीच में आकर इसकी विस्तार में हम लोग जानकारी दें. तो माननीय वित्त मंत्री जी आपको अगली जानकारी देंगे कि आज किस सेक्टर को लेकर हम आप सबके बीच में आए हैं, लेकिन बोल्ड रिफॉर्म
में लगातार काम चलता रहेगा।
सर, ब्रॉडली एक्सप्लेन्ड अबाउट द रिफॉर्म स्टेप्स व्हिच वी टेकन ड्यूरिंग द प्रीवियस 14 टू 19 टेन्योर ऑफ दिस गवर्नमेंट एंड आफ्टर द 2019 इलेक्शंस द जुलाई बजट वॉज presented, post that immediately in this very hall we met several times over several fortnights when we had to respond to the call of the hour, the need of the need which was felt by the SMEs and many others. And all this only to underline the fact that you're speaking with a sensitive, a responsive and a government which believes in consultation. So then after that, the budget of February 2020 was presented, but soon after came Corona. And after the parliament session was concluded, within hours of the announcement of the lockdown, the PM Garib Kalyan package was announced, about which MOS has briefly referred. The numbers are something which are worth recalling here because we are going to have to build on that. 52,606 crores into DBT account of 41 crore bank account holders, the Jan Dhan account holders. 18,000 crore worth grain and pulse transfers happened, in which 48 lakh metric tons of wheat and rice have been distributed, costing 69 crores. To 69 crore account ration card holders. 71,738 metric tons of pulses have been distributed to 6.25 crore card holders. Aside from this, non-card holders have also been distributed grains. And I mentioned a minute ago about the Ujjwala scheme, which helps distribution of free cylinders. Divyang and old age pensioners have all been also given assistance. So after the lockdown, within a couple of hours, meaning within a day or two, we came with that announcement of the Garib Kalyan package. With that, there was also a compliance and also due diligence related deadline dates which were postponed so that ease of compliance could come in. Beginning today, I come over to speaking about today, beginning today, for the next few days, I shall be coming with this entire team before you to put out the details of the vision which PM has put forth yesterday. So PM's vision for a self-reliant India, we will come with the details in various tranches beginning today. And we shall not forget in each of the tranches that we are talking about that we do have a responsibility towards the poor of this country, towards the needy of the country, towards the migrant workers of this country, the Divyang and the aged. So the tranches will of course be for all our convenience, suitably bringing grouped items which have some correlation. Alongside, you also had the Reserve Bank of India coming up with a lot of liquidity infusion, about which the data which will be shared with you all will go into greater detail about the quantum that they came up with, the LTROs and the TLTROs. I'm not getting into it so that you'll get the data, but we are not going into it. We also ensured, the Revenue Secretary is here, we also ensured that 18,000 crores of refunds through a special drive were given for all the income tax taxpayers. Drawback were also given the payments. So the intention being liquidity should be in the hands of the people. For all those who have up to 5 lakhs of refund dues, we cleared it. 14 lakh taxpayers have benefited because of that. So with that said, today the tranche has about 15 different measures, 6 of which pertain to the micro, small and medium enterprises. Kutir lagu udyog ke liye 6 aise kadam hum utayenge. 2 relate to the employees provident fund. 2 relate to the NBFCs, housing finance corporations and the MFIs, microfinance institutions. 1 relates to DISCOMs, 1 relates to contractors, 1 relates to real estate, and 3 are tax measures that we've taken. So I'll get into the detail of today's tranche of announcements. I said there are 6 major steps for the MSMEs. The first one, there is a collateral-free automatic loan for MSMEs which is being provided. This will give facility up to 3 lakh crores. 25 crore outstanding for those MSME units for whom 25 crore is the outstanding loan, or 100 crores whose turnover is, will benefit from this. These loans will have a 4-year tenor and there will be a moratorium given for 12 months. These are going to be 100% credit guaranteed over as a cover given to banks and NBFCs on principal and interest. So this is going to be